Crime Prevention Through Environmental Design, or CPTED, is a discipline which outlines how the properly designed physical environment can prevent crime by directly affecting human behavior. Mm-hmm. This guides us in loss and crime prevention by proper facility construction and environmental components and procedures. This encompasses the physical, social, and psychological needs of the users. Mm-hmm.
Now, crime prevention through environmental design concepts were developed in the 1960s. They have since matured. CPTED has been used to develop corporate physical security programs and also for development of neighborhoods, towns, and cities. It outlines how to design and develop landscaping, entrances, facility and neighborhood layouts, lighting, road placement, and traffic circulation patterns. We can use the CPTED for offices, restrooms, and campuses and cities. CPTED consists of the physical, social, and psychological needs of the users.
Cool. Yeah, and CPTED also has three main strategies that will bring together the physical environment and social behavior to improve overall protection. These strategies are natural access control, natural surveillance, and natural territorial reinforcement. Now, we're going to be looking at these three strategies in more depth.
Mm-hmm. First, we'll discuss natural access control. This is the guide of people entering and leaving the environment through doors, fences, lighting, and even landscaping. The landscape, sidewalks, lighted posts, and clear sight lines are used as natural access controls. They create in individuals a feeling of safety and work as deterrents of criminals. The following controls are normally used for access controls within different organizations, and those are: limit the number of entry points, force all guests to go to a front desk and sign in before entering the environment, reduce the number of entry points even farther after hours and during the weekends when a few employees are around, implement sidewalks and landscaping to guide the public to a main entrance.
Also, implement a back driveway for suppliers and deliveries, which is not easily accessible to the public. Mm-hmm. You can provide lighting to the pathways the public should follow to enter a building to help encourage that entry as one used for access. Implement sidewalks and grassy areas to guide vehicle traffic to enter and exit only through specific locations. You can provide parking in the front of the building so people would be directed to enter the intended entrance.
Mm-hmm. The main purpose of natural surveillance is to make criminals feel insecure by creating ways others could potentially see them. Mm-hmm. This also makes employees feel safe and comfortable by having an open and well-designed environment. We can create natural surveillance by using and placing physical environmental features, personnel walkways, and activity areas in ways that maximize visibility. A stairway in a parking garage should be designed to be open and allow easy observation. Walkways and bicycle paths are designed so that there will be a steady flow of pedestrians who could identify malicious activity.
Yeah, and then the third CPTED is natural territorial reinforcement. This creates physical designs to emphasize an organization's physical atmosphere of influence to make legitimate users feel a sense of ownership of that environment. And we can deploy territorial reinforcements by using the walls, fences, landscaping, light fixtures, flags, marked addresses, and decorative sidewalks. Companies deploy these elements for the employees to feel proud of their environment and have a sense of belonging so that they will protect it when needed.
Mm-hmm.
Now, these elements are deployed to give potential criminals the impression that they do not belong there and that their activities are being watched and will not be tolerated or ignored.
Correct. Now, man traps and turnstiles can be used so unauthorized individuals entering a facility cannot get in or out if it is activated. A man trap is a small room with two doors. If the first door is locked, a person will be identified and authenticated by a security guard, biometric system, or a card reader.
Yeah, and if the person is authenticated and authorized, the first door will open and allow the person into the man trap.
Mm-hmm.
The first door will be locked and the person is trapped. The person should be authenticated again if he wants to unlock the second door to access the facility. And some man traps use biometric systems and allows only one person at a time into the man trap area. This is a control that counteracts piggybacking.
Many internal components should be looked at from a security perspective. Internal partitions can be used to create barriers between one area to the other. These internal compartments can be used to segment separate work areas. We should never use internal compartments in protected areas which house sensitive systems and devices. Many buildings have dropped ceilings, which are interior partitions and are not extended to the true ceiling. A criminal can lift a ceiling panel and climb over the partition. We should not use these types of internal partitions and should not rely upon them to provide protection for sensitive areas.
Right. Personnel should be allowed into computer and equipment rooms for proper maintenance and operations only. We have technology so that most servers, routers, switches, mainframes, and other equipment in computer rooms can be controlled remotely. Mm-hmm. This gives the computer rooms with fewer people milling around and spilling coffee. Right? These rooms should be constructed in a manner that is efficient for equipment instead of people. Smaller systems can be stacked vertically to save space or placed in racks or inside equipment cabinets. The wiring should be close to the equipment. This will save on cable costs and will reduce tripping hazards.
Yeah. Computer and equipment rooms should be restricted areas. They should not be directly accessible from public areas like stairways or corridors. This will ensure that people cannot be in those secured areas without a specific purpose for being there.